Hello and welcome to Parenting in Diaspora. Today we're going to be discussing the top 5 immigrant success habits. It is a fact that immigrants are successful wherever they find themselves, and this is in spite of the obstacles that they have to deal with. For instance, usually when immigrants come to whatever country they come to, they don't have enough money. You know, many times people come in with $100, £200 and probably their suitcases. Sometimes people have to sell everything they have just to be able to, you know, go to where they're going. So there's that barrier. There's the language barrier. A lot of people go to countries where they don't speak the native language. And even when you do, sometimes people don't understand what you're saying and you don't understand what they're saying. And you might have to even go to school under those circumstances. And then there's just the sheer different culture that you have to unlearn some of the culture that you come with and have to relearn in your new place of abode. But in spite of all these obstacles, immigrants still succeed. And there's even a phenomenon for that, which is called the immigrant paradox. So in this video, we're going to explore what those habits are that make immigrants successful. And I'm going to discuss immigrants in 3 parts. First generation immigrants are those who come to the diaspora as adults. So for the most part, you know, we are successful academically, professionally, business-wise, so a combination of those. And there are reasons for that success. Now, the second generation immigrants are children who are either born in the diaspora or brought to the diaspora as children. That group has also been found to be very successful. As a matter of fact, more successful than their parents in many ways. Many times they are able to earn higher income, have a higher level of education, more opportunities, more exposure. They're able to be more, do more. They have the support of their parents. They don't have a lot of the barriers that we have, and they do well. Now, the group that has been termed the third generation immigrants, and the reason for this video, are those children who are born to second generation immigrants. So their parents were either born in the diaspora or came to the diaspora as children. This group statistics is showing that they are not doing as well as their parents and their grandparents academically, professionally, and you know, unfortunately, they are even more prone to get involved with the criminal justice system. There's a problem with that. The Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. So we have this knowledge out, and now we have to be intentional about doing something about it. Every parent wishes that their child will be greater and better than they are. So if going down our generations as immigrants, generations down are not doing as well as people before them, is something that should give us concern. So what are those 5 principles or habits that make immigrants successful that we should pass on to our generations? Number one is having no sense of entitlement. We actually don't have a choice. When we come in, most of the time we are not citizens, so we're not able to get all the advantages. We don't have medical aid, we don't have loans for school, many times we have to pay international fees. So we don't have all those things. So, and we know we are not entitled, we know we can't have them, so we don't think about them, rather we're just grateful. Sometimes even when you have friends or family that have gone ahead of you, they're not usually in the position that they can actually help you with your financial problems. So it's just you and God. I remember just a few months after we moved to the United States, I worked with a woman who told me that she grew up very poor. And so she made up her mind that she was going to give her children everything they wanted. She said, I ended up raising selfish children. And that's exactly what happens when we don't pass this habit of having no sense of entitlement to our children. They feel like the world owes them something, and instead of putting in their own effort, they're expecting all the time. And children like this have been found not to even be able to give because they're just so used to getting. They're not even able to be compassionate even towards their own parents just because of the fact that they've always been able to have whatever they wanted. Number two is delayed gratification. Again, that's an area where we really don't have a choice. Many times when we come in to different countries, we're not able to even begin practicing our professions without having to take some exams. Some people have to retrain all over. So you really can't get into the system, and so you have to learn to wait. So you can't reach the financial success that you want immediately. You just, you know, wait your turn. And that is something that also builds character and helps us to succeed. Unfortunately, the children who are now born in the diaspora don't have that problem many times, because if they don't have money, there's the credit card system, which we did not grow up with. But I've never seen someone who got rich on credit cards. And so if we don't pass this value of having delayed gratification and being able to wait, then our children may not be able to achieve the level of success that we have achieved. Number three is strong work ethic. Again, growing up where many of us came from, you didn't have a choice. There are some children who have to probably sweep the whole house, cook for everyone, before they even go to school, probably go out and sell some things before they go to school. Some people have to walk miles to even get the water that they're going to have their bath with. Some people just have to do so many things. Our parents told us stories of living in other people's homes and being treated as slaves, but you know, all of them ended up being successful. Now, for our children, being raised in the diaspora, you don't have all those problems. You turn on the tap and the water comes out. The school bus is waiting to pick you up outside, or you drive your children to school. So we have to actually artificially create hard work for our children. Otherwise, they're not going to experience it at all. And they need it for their development. They need it to succeed. And so at home, we need to let our children wash the dishes. Even if you have a dishwasher, they need to wash dishes, sweep the floor, mop the floor, mow the lawn, wash your cars, carry luggage, you know, up and down. You know, we just need to just make sure that our children are working. And what does this do for them? It just makes them capable. They're going to find themselves in different situations in life where they'll be able to handle things. They will not be overwhelmed with all that they have to do. It will just be second nature for them to do these kinds of things. So we're really helping to prepare our children for the future when we just, you know, teach them hard work. Number four is just passing on good values to our children. Values like perseverance, hanging in there, waiting your turn, getting out of your comfort zone to do things that are uncomfortable. We had to do all of that, and it has served us in good stead. The spirit of hospitality. Many times we are hospitable, we know what to do, but then we are raising children who don't know how to be hospitable, who cannot be warm and enthusiastic about visitors, and all these in just ways that you cannot imagine. Really go with them wherever they go and either give them favor or disfavor. The culture of respect, of courtesy, we shouldn't think that all those things belonged in the past. Really, all these values are still very relevant even now, and our children are blessed when they can exhibit all these values. And finally, if you watch any of my videos, you know I'm gonna say this, is the fact that because we're bilingual, that has been an advantage for us. Being bilingual just helps our brains to be able to process some complex situations that just help us to be able to move through life and succeed just because of that. And so helping our children, our grandchildren, our descendants to be bilingual is actually something that's gonna help them. So obviously, immigrants don't have a monopoly of success. All that I've outlined are really principles that anyone can use and be successful. I'm gonna end with a quote from a friend of ours, Dr. Yemi Badiru. He has this to say about success. He says, "Repeated success is by no means accidental, but is a result of certain principles and values that, if applied, will bring success every time." And so as I close today, I thank you and I wish you and your generation success in every area of your life. Thanks for watching. Until next time, God bless.